out of the ticket price, they would deduct overheads like venue hire, security, equipment, and the rest was split, up to 65-35 between artist and promoter. But promoters were renowned for inventing overheads and finding other ways of increasing their profit. One man confronted these promoters head-on and changed the world of live performance forever. The enormous Peter Grant.
I went to his house once. Let's go out onto the balcony and we'll get a machine gun and shoot bottles in the moat. Great. It was rock and roll.
What does Led Zeppelin manager Peter Grant do when he finds bootleg recordings of his group?
I personally go and confiscate the records.
And how do you do that?
I just walk in and take them.
Do some of the group's employ heavies to...
Well, they're not going to get anybody heavier than me, are they?
A lot of times the bands or the singers, you know, pop singers, they'd never even see their managers. He traveled with them. He was with them all the time. Very few managers did that. Peter Grant was out for his band.
Don't fucking talk to me. It's my bloody act.
He just had a way of dealing with people. He'd speak, you know, a bit like this, see, you know. And you had better do what I'm telling you. I'm sure that a lot of people watching this have seen the Led Zeppelin film.
Doesn't matter, as long as there's an extra nickel to be drained by exploiting Led Zeppelin, it's great.
Promoters were always his pet hate. That happened more or less every day.
You rented it and you control it, isn't selling fucking pirate posters.
I recall one incident in Chicago. We were doing a club and I think the ticket price was $7. And a roadie had spotted the promoter outside one of the side doors, letting kids in and just taking the money. Peter Grant got in the back of the queue. He didn't notice it was Peter Grant in the queue until he saw these Zuni Indian rings that he used to have in his fingers. And I'll never forget, Peter said, "I'll have that, thank you very much," and snatched the bag off the guy's hand. But he was there defending his artist.
Good evening. It really was the biggest crowd ever assembled for a single performance in one place in the entire history of the world. The name of the group, Led Zeppelin.
Audiences grew so massively. I mean, back then, even playing an arena was remarkable. I think Peter Grant was one of the first people to realize that the artist had a lot more power than had previously been recognized. You didn't have to do what promoters said. You didn't have to give them 50%. You could say, no, we don't need you. We'll give you a lot less and get away with it. And he did.
So they said, okay, you can give us 90% of the net income. Astonished a lot of people, but that was their deal. And if you wanted to book Led Zeppelin, that's what you had to pay. And eventually, that became the model.
Zeppelin's 73 tour of America was the first to go stadium scale. It grossed $4 million, $22 million in today's money. But you can bet they fought for every penny, and Grant questioned every dodgy scam. Because 7 years later, me and Ozzy were still dealing with the same people.